First Avenue, I've been to First Avenue for a ton of shows, but there's one that sticks out in my mind. And I just remember the whole night like it was yesterday. So it was fall 2006, Joan Jett was coming to First Avenue. Eagles of Death Metal were on the road with her. So they opened the show. I think it was a co-headlining bill. I remember a bunch of, you know, staffers from The Current were gonna go out and see Joan Jett, but we gotta get there early for Eagles of Death Metal. I had just joined Minnesota Roller Girls. So I had this new friend from roller derby that I was gonna bring to the show. And it was just like the perfect setup to the night. Well, it couldn't get any more perfect because my colleague Lindsay, for some reason, had the phone number of Joan Jett's longtime tour manager and producer, this guy Kenny Laguna. So before the show, before Joan Jett was gonna go on stage, we had gotten the news that Sandy West was the drummer for the Runaways. And so Sandy West and Joan Jett knew each other since they were teenagers. Well, we got the news that she had passed away. They paved the way, you know, they paved the way for female rock bands. Anyway, Lindsay gets the call that we can go backstage and meet Joan Jett. And I actually get like kind of shaky thinking about that moment. What do you say to someone that you admire as much as I admire Joan Jett? I had nothing to say. I did, but like I didn't want to say it all at the same time. So we go backstage in the green room at First Avenue to meet her. And then I looked over on the table and you see like the catering and what people have on their, you know, food list. There was a stack of bananas on that counter, none like I'd ever seen. And all I could say was, wow, that's a lot of bananas. But what I wanted to say is I wanted to give her my condolences for the loss of her friend, you know, somebody that, again, they like change, they helped change the world for women in music. And I wanted to tell her, but I didn't want to do it right before her show. Like, I didn't want to be, you know, sorry about your friend. And anyway, I finally got up the guts to just say hello because it got awkwardly quiet in the green room. And finally, Joan Jett was like, oh, my voice is bothering me. I don't know. I'm like, you're going to sound great. And then we stood in silence and she goes, so are we gonna do this picture? And I'm like, yeah, we should probably do the picture. And I was wearing a Buzzcocks t-shirt and she thought that was cool. It was a great time and it was just a night that I'll never forget at First Avenue.